Welcome back, guys. Welcome back to my channel. Today in this short tutorial, I'll show you guys how to create this cool 3D logo in Adobe Illustrator. Before we start, let's look into our sponsorship message first. Today's video is brought to you by Domestika. Domestika is a platform specially designed to provide courses related to art, design, photography, fashion, and music and audio. Right now, they are having special discount. Some of these courses have more than 78% discount. And if you guys use the sign up link below in the description with the coupon code, you will get additional 10% discount as well. Alright guys, so the first thing what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw the grid for the logo. So we will draw the grid and we will draw the logo on top of the grid. So for this, I'm not going to stick to any size. We can have any custom size. We can rescale it. Okay. So first, I'm going to select this line in here and draw a long line like this. Alright. And then I'm going to select this line. Press and hold the Alt key and make a copy. We can place it in here. Now, we're going to select both of these. Maybe we can align them to the top and go to the blend tool in here and select once in here and once more in here. All right. And again, I will go back in here, open the blend tool. Instead of smooth color, I need to have specific steps. Okay. For this, let's say I want 6 or 7 steps in between. Okay. Now, if you guys preview, so we will have 7 lines in between. We should be enough. Okay. So I'm just going to select okay. And now I will go to the rotation tool and I'm going to rotate this to 60 degrees. Okay. Double click to open. So 60 degree is going to be our angle of the logo as well. And I'm just going to select OK. All right. And now I will go back in here to the same tool and select the reflect tool and double click to open the reflect tool. This time I need to make a vertical copy. Just select copy in here. All right. So now we have this shape in here. You guys can make this one a little bit longer as well. So I'm just going to make it longer. Hold on to the Alt key, which will affect both sides like this. Okay. Same for this one in here also. All right. Now we can select all of them and make it a little bit more smaller. As I said, guys, I'm not worried about the size. After we create the logo, we can edit the size. All right. So now I will draw a line in here. Go back to the line tool and draw a line overlapping these crossing areas. Make sure your lines are exactly on the crossing areas in here. Okay. So you can go to the view in here and on all these snap to grid and snap to the points, which will automatically snap to these points like this. All right. So you have to on the smart guides and on the snap to the pixels and smack to the points like this. All right. Okay. So I will zoom out and make another copy, Alt and drag. This time I'm going to place it in here. All right. Okay. Now select both of these and align them to the center. Okay. Again, go back to the blend tool in here and select once in here and second one will be this one in here. Again, go back to the blend tool, double click to open. So instead of smooth colors, we have to select specific steps. So we need to have 11 steps in between. We have 11 crossing paths, crossing lines in here. So just select 11. And select OK. So now you guys can see we have these lines perfectly aligned with these crossing areas. Okay. Now you can select this and make it bigger to cover the entire portion. All right. Okay, guys, I think this is looking cool. Now we can go to object and expand these lines as well. Now we have all of these as one single line. So now you can select all of them and make as a group, control G. Okay. All right. So we can go to a new layer, or you guys can draw that in the same layer. Now I'm going to draw the logo. Okay. So I'm going to start from the top T shape in here. So first we need to define how many boxes we are going to have. So I'm going to use 1, 2, 3, these three boxes, and 1, 2, 3, these three boxes. So we will have 3, 3, and from here we will have the logo going below. Okay, so let's start from the top three. Go and select the pen tool in here. Make sure you have selected the smart guides and the snap to grid and pick points are on. Now go in here. I'm going to start from here. 1, 1, 2, 3. This one in here. And we go to this one. And this one will end in here. And now 1, 2, 3. Okay. Here. One more point in here. And the next one will be in here. Then we can close this shape like this. Okay. You guys can zoom in and edit these and place these anchor points in correct places. All right. So the second shape will start from here and go three lines, three boxes below, and it will close from here. So I will go and start drawing that one. Go in here. We'll go to this one. 1, 2, 3. And like this. And one more below. Now we will have three more boxes to this side, and go in here. Yeah, 1, 2, 3. We are close. Okay. So I'm just going to add some colors for you guys so you can easily see them in here. So for this, I'm going to apply the pink color, and for this, I'm going to apply the blue color. All right. So now we have one shape in here, another shape in here. Okay. So the third shape is going to be in here. 3, and this one in the center, 3. Okay. First, I don't need any color for this. Make none and go back in here. Now we start from here. One box in here, one box in here, this side, and all the way 3. And we go back in here. And this will be our final T shape. All right. Okay. And we can edit this and place them in correct places. All right, guys. And for this, let's apply a green color. Okay, so now we have the base T shape in here. All we need to do is add the 3D shape. Okay, and for this, I'm going to select a yellow color. Now, let's start from here. Go to the pen tool again. Apply a box like this. This will be the cross section of the pink T. All right. Same for this one also. And one for this one. And one in here. Okay. Then again, I'm going to change the color to something light. Now we will draw these shapes in here. Okay. Start from this one. So we will have something like this in here. And for this, we will have something like this. I'll change the color a bit. And for this, we will have something like this. All right. Or one more in here and apply this color. All right. Now the last portion is going to be this shape in here. It's this area. We have to have a triangle. I'll go and select the pen tool and draw a shape like this. Okay. One in here. One in here. And one in here. And I forget to add one more in here for this T. So I'll draw. All right, guys. So that's all. Now all we need to do is edit these points and place them in the correct area. Once you place them in the correct place, you guys can add in any color, and then we will get this cool 3D logo. All right, guys, so that's all about it for today. You guys can create any type of 3D looking objects using this grid method. And thank you for watching. See you guys in the next tutorial.